it came to pass that on that that conversation with Richard Fuse was on August 6th. I called the office of the Attorney General by August 7th or August 8th, very quickly. And when I called their office, they said, holy God, you better call. They gave me a phone number, and they said I should call the Office of Counterterrorism and repeat what I had just told them to the to those people.
カウンターテロリズムって言って、対テロ対策室っていうのがありましてね、そこにも同じような計画を、計画があるということで、事前警告をはっきり具体的に与えました。上司と命令を受けたのは8月6日、で実際、司法省やテロ対策の、テロ対策のチームにこの話をしたのは8月7日と8月の8日でした。
I have since learned that John Ashcroft complained to his private staff in August of 2001 that people kept making these warnings about terrorism and it was really boring and he didn't want to hear it anymore.
後から分かったことですけど、このアッシュクロフト司法長官は各いろいろな情報機関からこの8月に集中して苦労が起きますよという警告を方々から受けたんですね。それで自分のスタッフに対してもういい加減疲れたわと、こんなにのあちこちから言われたって自分は聞いたところで何もできないしということで、いわゆる知ってた聞いてたけれどもそれを真摯に受け止めたという様子はなかったような気がします。
In which case he could have been speaking about me but I did our team did everything that we could do butAnd this is the thing where you have to understand how factions work. We could be working very hard on one track, and somebody else is working hard on the other track. And they're going in exactly the opposite direction that we're going in. Which is, okay, sorry.
情報機関といっても一枚岩じゃないんですね。ある機関は別の利害を代表し、別の機関は別の利権を代表しているので、同じ情報を得てもものの言い方や止めるのかそれを増長するのかとか方向性が正反対に行く場合もあるので、一番岩にはいかないんですね。
And that's very important for understanding what happened in the month of August of 2001 becauseWhile we were trying to get actionable intelligence to stop the attack, when I was writing my book called Extreme Prejudice, I was approached by somebody at the very high level security clearance, extreme insider knowledge that of a degree that very impressive level of intelligence. And I won't tell you what he said, but to explain that first.
まず2001年の8月、そのような動きをしたことということが、自分が一番警告を発してたと、まあ、ちょっと自慢ですけれども、ジョン・アッシュ・クロフト当時の司法長官は知ってるから発言してくれても良さそうなのに、まあ、自分のことは表に出なかったんですが、この度冤罪被害者となった後になって最近、エクストリームプレジャディスという題名の本を初めて自費出版することになりまして、それがこの10月に出るんですけれども、英語でエクストリームプレジャディスっていうのは極端な偏見っていうのが直訳ですけれども、これは CIA の隠語、用語でですね、専門用語で暗殺せよというコード名なんですね。で暗殺せよっていうんですけど、その直訳だと面白くないので邪魔者を消せ、そんな題名で私は翻訳を頼まれたので、この本が英語で出たら私が日本語でもし訳すなら邪魔者を消せにしたいんですけど、ついさっきやっぱりあなたは翻訳しなくていいとかって言ってるのでどうなるか分かりませんけど、翻訳するなら私は邪魔者を消せという題名で日本語にしたいと思いますね。
So did you tell them about the planting the bombs?
それで。
Okay, no, well, okay. Okay, so what, Sarah has heard the story so many times, so she knows all the details. It's actually very important because I have learned from this very supremely outstanding source that in the month of August, the second part of August, There was some very strange activity at the World Trade Center. At about 2-3 o'clock in the morning. He said that after the, it was definitely not janitorial trucks. He said that the janitorial services had, would leave for the day, and they'd be there late at night. And about 2 o'clock, 3 o'clock, 4 o'clock, trucks were arriving at the World Trade Center for about 3 weeks. And they were unexplained trucks. They didn't have a reason for being there. Except they were just, and they had never been there before. This was not a pattern. The building's been around for how, had been around for 20 years, 30 years, whatever. This was not part of the routine. This was a break in the routine. And yet the trucks were entering through the basement, and somebody was bringing things in, bringing stuff into the World Trade Center, and they'd work for a couple of hours, and they'd leave. And that there might be 5 or 6 trucks at a time.
Okay? 8月の第2週からその3週間くらいあったおかしな動きをある信頼のおける筋から自分は事後に聞いたことがあるんですけれども、ワールドトレードセンターっていうのは深夜にいつも掃除するんですけど、掃除が終わった後の時間帯、深夜の3時ぐらいからですね、3週間にわたって巨大なトラックが頻繁に出入りして、通常ではない動きをして何かを運び込んでいるような、あの状態で、お掃除する人たちっていうのはもう3時までには終わってますから、この真夜中に一体何をやってるんだとおかしく思ってた人たちがいたのは事実ですね。
And he told me that he absolutely believes, he's just convinced that that's when they wired the building. And、he and I agree that airplanes definitely were hijacked. We absolutely agree they flew into the building, they smashed into the building, and obviously the building then fell. But what we think happened, and I agree with him, is that in it, that the CIA understood, into all the intelligence community,knew the attack was coming, and they had all, the highest, a faction of the Bush administration, the crazy people in the Bush administration, had already decided they were going to go to war with Iraq, and therefore somebody else came in, and it could be U.S. intelligence, it could be Israeli intelligence, but we don't know.But somebody definitely came in and wired that building to guarantee the outcome, which they already knew would be war with Iraq. And as you will, one of the things that's very interesting is that the buildings fell very quickly after the attack, and they came down like a demolition. And the movie Zero is beautiful. You've got to see that movie. It's outstanding. It's great. It definitely came down as they waited until all the people, it's interesting, they waited until all the people were out of the building, and then when everybody was out of the building, they detonated it. And that's why more people did not die. But the United States knew that's what happened, that's what we think happened. And that's why there's thermite found in the building, which is molten.Oh, it's like molten C4. It's a sulfur. It's a compound of sulfur and C4 and it burns through metal, burns through steel at a very high degree. And you should see the movie Zero. That's a beautiful movie. You've got to see that movie.
それで最後に繰り返し言ってたのはゼロというイタリア製のドキュメンタリーで911の真実を。追っている関係者とか内部告発者が出てくるので非常にいい映画で、これはイタリアや他のソ連とか他のごめんロシアとか他の国でもうすでに放映されてるんですけど、それが昨日東京で初上映だったので私たち招待されて広島公演の後とんぼ帰りして東京でその映画を夜見たんですけれども、彼女の感想なんですが、その実際に使われていた米軍の施設でしか作り得ない超高温になる、特殊爆弾であるサーマイトが、爆破に使われたという証拠になるような残留物の硫黄のようなものが残されていたとか、詳細の証言が出てくるので、偏見なく陰謀説ではなくそういう、証拠検証ができるという意味でこの映画を見るのはぜひおすすめします。